Today we're going to migrate a Plex server to another machine. If you already have a Plex server on a PC, you may be wondering how to move everything over to another PC without having to recreate everything from scratch. Migrating a Plex server properly avoids having to recreate your libraries and scraping all your metadata from IMDb and TVDB, which can be very time-consuming, especially if you have hundreds or even thousands of movies or TV shows. I should mention that there is a distinction between the Plex server and the Plex media files. While you may have a Plex server on one machine, that doesn't mean you need to have the media files residing on the same machine. In fact, I have my media files located across several QNAP NAS file servers, and I simply point to those network folders from my Plex server, which also means I don't have to migrate the media files themselves. This makes things easier to migrate the server. With that said, even if you have to move your media files along with the Plex server, it's not that difficult. I'll talk about that later in the video. So why would you want to migrate your server? The most common reason is to move your Plex server to a more powerful machine. Remember, Plex recommends a CPU with a passmark score of roughly 2000 to transcode a 1080p video at 10 megabits per second, or a passmark of 1500 for a 720p video at 4 megabits per second. Using this guideline, if you want to stream two 10 megabit per second 1080p movies at the same time, you'll need a CPU with a passmark of about 4000. In my case, I'll be moving not only to a faster machine, but I'll also be moving from Windows Server 2012 R2 to Windows Server 2016. I'm going to start on my destination machine, which I'll be moving the Plex server to. You'll first want to go to plex.tv and download the installer for the Plex Media Server. I'll opt to open it as soon as it's downloaded. This will take a while, so I'll skip ahead. Once the installer launches, click the Install button and wait for the installation to finish. Again, I'll fast forward a bit. Once it's done, I'm not going to launch the server. Instead, I'll just close the installer for now. Let's move over to the source machine that has the existing Plex server. After logging into the server, click on the Settings icon and tab to the Server Options. Clicking over to Library, make sure the checkbox for Empty Trash Automatically After Every Scan is unchecked, then save the changes. Next, you don't have to do this, but I prefer to shut down my server completely. Right-click the Plex icon in the notification tray and exit the server. You'll need to transfer two pieces of information to the new server. First, you have to transfer all the files in the local app data location. Using Windows File Explorer, type %localappdata%\plexmediaserver, which will take you directly to that folder. You'll want to compress all the content in the Plex Media Server folder. By right-clicking that folder, you can choose to compress it using Windows internal zip utility. Or if you have 7-zip, like I do, you can zip it up that way. Keep track of the location of the compressed file because you'll need to transfer that later. Depending on how much media you have, this can be a huge amount of data and thus a very long operation. To save time, you could have excluded the cache folder if you wanted to, but in the overall scheme of things, the contents of that folder constitutes a small percentage of data. The second piece of information that you need to transfer is the registry. Go to the Start menu and type in RegEdit. After you open the registry editor, you'll need to navigate to HKEY Current User, then Software, then Plex Incorporated, and finally Plex Media Server. Right-click that entry and choose Export. Give it a name and hit Save. Again, keep track of where you save this file because you'll need to transfer it later to the new machine. Now, take a coffee break and I'll come back when the compression's complete. Okay, we're back. If you get a warning message from 7-Zip stating that the Plex update service log is being used by another process, don't worry about it. It's just a log file, and there is indeed an update service that is running in the background. It's just a log file that you don't need. You can close the dialog box at 99% because 7-Zip will never be able to get that last log file. But rest assured, the zip file has been created. Now let's move over to our destination machine. As I mentioned before, you'll need to transfer the registry export and the zip file over to the new PC. You can do this by sending the files over the network, or by using a USB drive, or through remote desktop. At any rate, I've already placed my two files here in Windows Explorer. Let's first right-click the registry file and select Merge. After clicking Yes to confirm, this'll add the Plex Media Server entries into the new machine's registry. Next, you'll need to uncompress the contents of Plex Media Server into the same local app data location on the new PC. I'll move this zip file over by selecting Cut, navigating to %localappdata%, and pasting it to that folder. I'll open the zip file with 7-zip, and proceed to extract the subfolders into the Plex Media Server folder. After clicking OK, it'll complain that some of those subfolders already exist, so you'll want to overwrite all the folders and files by clicking Yes to All. Once again, this'll take some time, so I'll be right back. Once the files are unzipped, you'll want to restart the PC, which I've already done, and then start the Plex Media Server. Double-click the Plex icon in your notification tray to open Plex in your browser. You'll then want to log into your Plex account. My video capture is being done through remote desktop, so you may see some artifacts as it paints the screen. You can see that all my libraries are intact, and all my media information has transferred over successfully. Head over to Settings, tab over to Server, and sign out. You'll then want to click the Claim Server button to sign back in. One more thing that you'll need to do is to manage your libraries. My media files are out on the network, so my new Plex server is still pointing to them. All I need to do is select Scan Library Files for each library to update them, and everything will just work. However, if you're moving your media files to another location, you'll need to add that new location to your library folder settings. I won't save the changes, but once you've updated your library, you can then delete the old location, which should be empty since you'd already moved those files over to the new location. You'll want to do this not only for every folder that you're pointing to in this library, but for each and every library. You'll notice that the Remote Access tab has a red exclamation mark next to it. So my Plex server isn't available outside my own network. That's easily fixable by simply changing your port forwarding on your router. Since I'm on a different IP address, all I need to do is enter my new address on my router. Once you've modified your port forwarding settings, you can see that the server is now available to the outside. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.